Hi, this is John and Evelina, and we raise Breezy for Guiding Eyes for the Blind. And we represent Guiding Eyes for the Blind when we raise Breezy and we make these videos. But we don't set policy, and sometimes we make mistakes. So in this video, we made some mistakes. The dogs behind me are playing with Squeaky Toy. So we just want to make it over and fill it with fun pictures and let people know that sometimes our videos have things in them that aren't supposed to be there, and we need to take them out. So your supervisors, listen to them. They know what policy is. And as puppy raisers, first-time puppy raisers, we're learning policy sometimes as we go along. You'll love this video with all the new fun pictures.
October 10th.
10th, yeah.
Oh, geez. What are you doing? What are you doing with that big bone?
We had the last evaluation test. We call them walk and talk. When you have to do certain stuff, and the instructor and regional manager watch you from behind.
Tell you what you have to do, there was some special stare thing, and the dog has to work a certain way. Yesterday, Breezy had maybe the most perfect day she ever had. She's a really good dog, but she's a hyper dog, always
and
has been hyper.
What we mean by perfect day, her big issue was walking properly, which I think is the major thing those dogs have to do. They have to be on your side, they cannot pull, they have to pay attention, what you want to do, what's your command. Like, it is a real teamwork. The dog and you are like one person.
Yeah, and the dog has to walk a little bit ahead, but keep in touch. The dog will eventually be harnessed, and so the dog doesn't just walk next to you and pick up your cues. It's a very strange thing. The dog can't fall behind. It can't go too far ahead. It has to constantly check with you. You're telling the dog when turns are coming up.
No. There's sniffing, no scavenging, you know, a lot of stuff. But it's not about that. It's about this.
It's about being connected to the person you're walking with. She has to be a team member. Be a team member, you have to keep track of the other people on your team. And it's a two-person team. But I think of these dogs as people.
Yeah.
And it's a two-person team, and the dog is a big part of it. But no more part of it than the sight-impaired person. And she's a jumpy dog. She's interested in smelling and chasing things. And over the almost year that we've had her, she has learned.
She made tremendous progress.
She goes everywhere with us. And she's not a typical guide dog because, training guide dog, because she has two razors. In a lot of houses, you don't get two people who really are two full raisers, and we are two full raisers, and we're basically in the house 24 hours with her. So,
and what I have to say, it's sometimes I think confusing for her because we both do stuff differently, and sometimes when I don't let her do something, she looks at John. It's like, how about you?
Good cop, bad cop.
Yeah, good cop, bad cop.
But I think
exactly.
It actually helps because the dog needs to be able to take commands from anybody. And
In the long run,
it's really helped out. But she had a phenomenal day yesterday, and she has really good days. She's really a good dog. She goes everywhere. I mean, everywhere. She's on the subway every day. We're on the subway. She goes to every restaurant. She doesn't get like a restaurant trip on occasion. She goes to every restaurant. If we go somewhere and she doesn't go, she's incredulous. She cannot believe she got left behind. And that almost never, ever, ever happens. Tomorrow we're going to the zoo. Breezy goes to the zoo. That people are just going to have to deal with it. You know, we won't take her in places that are going to bother other animals or herself.
Many times we called ahead to check if that it's not a problem. We understand that, you know, somebody can say no and we can't do much about it. We can educate people. We can, you know, say that she's in training, but most of the times people are thrilled to have her and help with the training process, mm-hmm. and they love to find out how all this training goes, and they like want to be involved in some way if they can.
Yeah, we told the whole bus. We came home on the bus today, and we told everybody on the bus Breezy's story. Everybody was interested. Everybody gets excited. People from other countries talk about doing something in their country. So we tell the story. We tell it. Oh, we're like the rhyme of the Ancient Mariner. Doggies everywhere.
Yeah, pretty crazy about our Breezy.
And she today, but, she had her test, and she was just...
Long story short, exactly.
Well, actually, long story short, which I'm glad you're here for this, is I want to talk about the big success here. about this dog, and really the big success of this dog is Evelina.
We're not talking about me.
I knew you were going to do that. That's why I tricked
because,
you here.
No.
This was my idea to do this dog.
I'm the big hero here.
Hey,
don't argue in front of camera.
I'm the one who wanted to go do this. Went to do this, and I chickened out. I couldn't give the dog back. But then when I found out it's about taking on a certain amount of pain and suffering to give a dog up that you're crazy for the good of someone else, change somebody's whole world, change the world of everyone around them. And that to find out that this is a good job for dogs, not a bad job, but a magical dog, one of the smartest animals in the world, so tightly bred to be a certain size and a super intelligence. If she's the super, super, super dog, she will not lead a blind person, not lead, be team with, that she's not the leader. They both work together. That she will be a brood. She will make other dogs. The top dogs don't work. They breed. Unless they have a different way of doing it, where they certain dogs, you know, they think are better for breeding, whatever. That she's the product of incredible breeding, and she loves to work. She loves to go to magical places. She's a dog that goes into a restaurant like she's been there 1,000 times, because actually she has been there 1,000 times. She's been to stadiums. She's been to hospitals. I mean, yeah, if I got to go to the hospital, Breezy has to go to the hospital.
Crazy busy stores.
And the doctors love it. Your doctors come in to see you in the hospital, and then you find out they're not even there for you. They're there to see the dog.
Yeah, many nurses.
That was the doctors.
Oh, I know.
They all loved the dog, and they were very, very good about it, because they get it. A blind person's going to need to be able to get in the hospital. Supermarkets. Breezy was at Trader Joe's again. Trader Joe's has only been in the neighborhood for 2 weeks. She's been there like seven times. That she was so good in there today. There's food on the floor in a million spots. She doesn't even fight to go to them anymore. She knows she cannot eat up the floor. That's a big deal. You get a dog to surrender, picking stuff up. That's the kind of training she's had, and that's the kind of dog she is. That she trusts us and believes in us. That she's going to be taken care of, she's going to be fed, she's going to be loved, she's going to be used in a very profound way. She's a smart dog, going to be doing a very important job, and she will see the world as a result of that. She is not a dog at home hoping she gets to go out and poop on the street in front of her building. This is a dog that's going to Yankee Stadium for the playoffs. City Field too, we love the Mets too. The day that Evelina became the primary raiser in this house.
It seems like your video.
Well, then you should jump in, because if you're going to play that you have a Polish accent and you don't want to talk, that's up to you. But you got to be able to fight your way in here. Evelina is the reason why the dog is doing so well. She really trains the dog differently than I do. She's very diligent. And I see the difference between the people in school that get their homework done the minute they get home and the people that are doing it on the bus on the way to school. More like me.
I take the first option.
We have the best of both worlds with her diligence and my freestyle techniques. That I really, really wanted to make this video for both of these fabulous ladies, but really for Evelina for doing the big job. Big job. You really are a phenomenal raiser. And it's just a simple thing.
I really think
repetition,
that it's
diligence,
teamwork. I don't think that Breezy would be so great if it wouldn't be because of me. I had a hard time, especially when we start train her. Every kind of failure, she didn't get what I want her to do. I took personally.
Oh, you used to get so upset.
I get so upset after Sunday classes. I came back home and I almost cried.
You were crying.
She didn't do what I want her to do. She didn't listen to me. She was distracted by other dogs. I had so much me in her. Like, I want her to do good. The same way when I was at school, I want to be, you know, a student, and I was. But I work hard, and I put so much work during the week, do the homework, everything. And we went to class, and that's it. My homework is not so great. she had amazing transformation. I think she mature and become such a intuit.
Yeah, she loves to show
up. Hardworking. She never, ever really, it's not like never, but when she went outside, she wanted fun. She didn't really treat that as a job, work. That's a part of the training. And we had long time really struggle with teaching her not to pull, not to get distracted by other dogs, not to scavenge, not to pick up things from the street.
So if you're a raiser and you're listening to this, you have to remember that it's about repetition, that we're a good team.
And
that for me, those things roll off. Maybe she didn't get it today. We don't have to have her ready tomorrow. We have this much time.
Mm-hmm.
Our job is to just keep doing it, but make the dog happy.
And
love
exactly.
The dog. Make the dog want to do it. Keep it fun and upbeat. It's repetition, 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 but not
and
simple repetition. It's fun repetition, exciting repetition.
Yeah.
And that we help each other. Because a lot of times, Evelina lets me know, John, you're saying this too much, or imagine me saying something too much.
No, I said for, you know, married couple or couple who raise the dogs together, it can be, you know, subject to a, you know, argument. And we don't want to say it was easy.
It's an opportunity for disaster.
Yeah, I like things a little differently. We go together to the class. After having a class, listen to the instructor, seeing how other dogs doing, we always try to make the best. And it's not about us, it's about the dog. And whenever, we have really great group of people.
Take the criticism.
They always help each other. Whenever you have a question, Rachel.
Well, Rachel's a joke. Because when she gives you criticism, you walk out with a big smile.
Yeah,
she's so loving and gentle.
I just want to say that we had many questions, you know, throughout that year. And there was no question she didn't know how to handle the way that, I don't know, I wanted to
do the
right
thing. Plus, she's crazy. She always says, that's a great question.
Yeah, and she always, like, show you. Okay, I said, I can teach her that. And Rachel was like, oh, let's see.
And she does it in a fun way.
Breezy was like, oh my God, she can do it.
Oh, and she had Breezy for a little bit today. And Breezy was so excited to have Rachel handle the leash and give her treats. She just loved that.
That's
right. We're really making this. I was making this video to brag about Breezy and Evelina. But we really want raisers.
I think you should take the biggest credit.
Okay. The thing about why we make these videos is because we want more people to do this. And we want you to know that you just keep moving forward. Don't worry about today. Because even the weirdest things you think they're not going to pick up, they just do.
Yeah.
The dogs are very intelligent. Just do it again the next day. Do it again the next day. And they learn it. When they learn it, they learn it. And they know it.
And they know.
They remember everything. I remember nothing.
I think they know how the system works. They know what they can do, what is good, what is not perfect. They just know.